Hello and welcome to another inorganic chemistry lesson. This time we'll discuss how to write a synthesis reaction between a compound and an element. If you are looking for the information regarding synthesis reaction between two elements or two compounds, I already covered these topics and you can find the links in the description. Synthesis reaction between compound and an element usually involves acidic oxides and oxygen. Let us look at the first example, where phosphorus-free oxide reacts with oxygen. Before writing the product for this reaction, you want to determine the phosphorus charge, which is 3+. And next, you need to remember that when writing this type of synthesis reaction, the charge always increases by 2. So in the product, phosphorus charge should be 5+. And it combines with oxygen, which has a charge of 2-. We swap charges with subscripts and get the P2O5 formula. In this case, we don't need to balance the equation because we have the equal amount of the same atoms on both sides of the reaction. Let's look at more examples. In this case, carbon 2 oxide reacts with oxygen. The carbon charge is 2+. So after the reaction, it should be 4+. We get C4+ and O2-. The chemical formula we get is CO2. To balance the equation, we add the coefficient 2 in front of CO and CO2. Now we have a reaction between sulfur 4 oxide and oxygen. The sulfur charge before the reaction is 4+. So sulfur after the reaction must be 6+, and oxygen once again is 2-. The formula is SO3, and to balance the equation, we write coefficient 2 in front of SO2 and SO3. Okay, now it's time for two last examples. In the first one, Cl2O5 reacts with oxygen. Cl charge is 5+, so after the reaction, it becomes 7+. Oxygen is 2-, like always, so the formula is Cl2O7. Lastly, we don't need to balance this reaction because we have an equal amount of atoms on both sides. Our last problem in today's lesson is a reaction between nitrogen 2 oxide and oxygen. Nitrogen is 2+, so after the reaction, it must be 4+. The product's chemical formula is NO2. If we write coefficient 2 in front of NO and NO2, we should have a perfectly balanced reaction. And that's it for today's lesson. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to this channel for more chemistry content. Like always, I leave a few exercises with answers that you can do on your own, and see you in the next lesson.